Hello everyone, in this video we will learn about the new paper trader in GoCharting. For that we need to go to broker, and here we will see GoCharting sim as a broker. We can also see GoCharting as a broker, so both of these are for paper trading. However, GoCharting is our old paper trader and the GoCharting sim is the new paper trader. In this new paper trader, all your positions, trade orders are saved in the cloud. So changing your computer, laptop or mobile does not affect your positions. So this is more advanced. Now let us see what are the features of GoCharting sim paper trader. So here we have a user ID. This is called demo123. You should click on I agree to terms and condition and simply you press on connect. Once the paper trader is connected, now here you will see trade, reset and logout buttons. You can also create a new account or delete the account. So now let us see how we can create a new account. So for that, you have to click on add account. Now you can give some names. For example, I can give the name as paper trader 2. I have option to select the currency, and here we can also enable the commissions. So friends, we know that we have to give commission to broker, and these are dependent on either percentage wise or the fixed commission. So from here, you can select either percentage, fixed or max of fixed and percentage or minimum of fixed and percentage. Then you can define your fixed commission as well as the percentage of the commission. And then you can also set your initial balance. If you click on apply, this account will be added over here. So now if you click on here, you have this paper trader 2. If you want to delete any account, say for example, if I want to delete this paper trader, I can select it and I can press on delete account. So this account has been deleted. Now we have only paper trader 2. This is how we have set our broker as GoCharting sim for paper trading. Now we need to keep in mind few things before doing the actual paper trading. Some people will be trying to trade on Nifty 1 continuous futures for paper trade. So friends, this will not happen because these are fabricated futures. These are not the futures where the trading is actually happening. Okay. And also you cannot trade on index. So you should make sure that you are selecting the symbol which is actually tradable. So if you want to trade Nifty futures, you should select these monthly futures, or you can also select the options. Okay. So options, because they are tradable, you can trade in the paper trading as well. Now we have the chart of ES over here. Now let me show you how to do the buying and selling. So for example, I want to buy the market orders for this. So I will select and I will click one lot of CME. Then I can go to the ledger section. Now in the ledger section, under my trades, you can see the trade had been executed. These are the orders. This is the position running over here. You can see the balance in this tab, and you can also see your analytics of the trade. Okay, so this is how you can check the ledger section. Now, if you want to delete all these trades from the paper trader, you can simply click on the reset button. Once you click on the reset, all these trades will be reset. Now, let me tell you how you can trade. So if you want to trade, there are basically three ways to trade. So first is this one click trade. You can simply press these buttons and place the market buy and sell orders. Say, for example, I want to buy this one lot, simply click, and this one lot will be bought at the market price. Now there are two buttons, that is this trade button, or from here buy and sell. You can do buy or sell, and for each buy and sell we have four kind of orders, that is limit order, market order, stop order and stop limit order. Now there are few observations. So for limit order you have to set only one single price. For market orders you don't have to select any price, you just simply press the buy or sell button and that will be executed at market price. For stop orders also, we have to select only one price. However, for a stop limit, we have to give two prices. This feature is useful, particularly in case of Nifty options, because in Nifty options, you cannot put market stop order, but you have to put the stop limit orders. So to help you that you don't have to put two prices again and again, we have given some spread settings that I will be explaining in few minutes. Then also you can set the take profit and stop loss, and also set the trailing stop loss. About those features we'll be talking in few minutes. So this was the second method, how you can place the orders. Now there is a third method. You can simply place order by right-clicking. So this is the current market price. If you place your cursor below the current market price, and suppose this is the 5160 line, if you place your cursor over here and right-click it, 5160 price level will be automatically selected. You can go for buy limit, buy market, sell stop, and sell stop limit. And then if you place your cursor above the current market price and then you right-click, now you will get sell limit, sell market, buy stop, and buy stop limit. So now you see this 5200 has been automatically taken as input because your cursor was at that price level. Okay. So now, because this is only one price input, now I have just told you, if you are putting the stop limit orders like this, you have to give two inputs, right? So now let us go to the setting and see what you can do. So go to the trading setting. Now here we have defined the trigger spread. Okay, that could be based on price, offset, ticks, and percentage. You can define the trigger spread, and here you don't have to fill the two prices. Okay, you just fill one price and right click at any price level. One price level and plus the trigger spread will be taken here. It will fill automatically. Now, second point is this quick trade mode. So if you switch off the quick trade mode and you simply right click and you press buy market. Now see, this trading panel is getting open. Now, if you enable the quick trade mode and simply go right click buy market, the trading panel will not open, but your order will be executed. So this was about the quick trade mode. Okay, then you can see these options. These are very simple options. And you can also define your SL spread and target price spread, which I have shown you over here. So these are your take profit and stop loss, which you can define over here. These are also based on the price, offset, ticks, and percentage. You have to switch on these settings. Okay, the same thing can also be done in options desk. So let me show you in the options desk. So this is our products. Go to options desk. Now here as well, we have this broker option and we have this GoCharting same option. Okay, so you can do the same trading here in the options chain by simply clicking buy or sell button. So here you have option of paper trade and the real trade. So you can do paper trading in the GoCharting sim if you are here in the option chain. You can also look the payoff chart under the risk tab, and you can again do the paper trading over here. For example, if you want to create a custom strategy, so you can simply click on add custom strategy, apply this, click on this plus button to add legs. Now here you can, suppose you want to sell a straddle, press on sell over here and sell over here. So this is your straddle, and you can simply click on paper trade and analyze your positions. Okay. And if you want to see your position, simply go to ledger, and from here you can check your positions. Since the market is closed, you're not able to see any positions, but that's how you are going to do it. So I hope you understood how to do paper trading in GoCharting. Thank you guys.